Back like we never left. SV here with a live reaction to The God of High School. This week, reading chapters 77 and 79. So let's get it. GOH chapter 77. Let's go. Right where we left off last time, we see that boy Mori with his finger on Ryo's forehead. Like, boy, don't come near me. And again, like, I'm so curious to this because the way this shit ended, I don't like how Ilpio was just smiling on the sidelines, bro. I don't like him just smiling like this, bro. You know what I mean? I don't like it. I don't like it, bro. Title card is fire. Like, I always say this. GOH has some of the best title cards, bro. They're just fantastic, bro. Like, the title card is so clean, bro. It's so clean. I absolutely love when they give us new ones, bro. It's great. It's great. It worked. Ah. Let me see. What happened? Let me see. Mori goes in for a kick. Did Ryu dodge that shit, though? Oh, no. We kicked him in his shin. Ryu. Jin's fifth attack. So Mori flips over him and lands on the other side, bro. I think right after Joker fight with Valkyrie, that Valkyrie guy, I think the episode is Jin and Ilpio. Oh, okay. Oh, so the fight with the Joker and Valkyrie's in the anime, that's pretty fire. I've seen that already. Man, I can watch that maybe. I've seen that already in the webtoon. So Mori lands on the other side. He's why? And we see. Flashback. It's not good for Ryu. Ryu getting a flashback, he's gonna get out of here, bro. So I gave him a blow. Hey, yo, pause. That's so funny. He says, why does it remind me of that time? And we see Ryu is here. Jumping rope. In a boxing gym. He's doing his thing. No, I won't. Huh? What did you just say? Say it again, idiot. What? And you see, he's thinking about this, but I'm curious to why. They don't show the fight. Wow, that's corny, bro. That's corny. They don't even show the fight? That's so trash, bro. So I'm curious to why Ryu was thinking about this little incident he had with these, like, I guess, bullies or people or whatever. He's like, Mori looks at him. But thanks to it, I feel like I'm undefeatable. Oh, okay. So he's thinking about the time when he fought against some bullies. He beat them up or whatever. And he's like, oh yeah, I feel invincible, quote unquote. Okay, brother. And as he says that, Mori speed puts him, taps him on the back of the head. And he goes, huh? Turns around, boom, gets hit. Huh? Boom, gets hit. Huh? Boom, gets hit. Re-taekwondo. Ah, is that Jin Ho-chuk? Swoosh. Beep. HP zero. As the man's talking, like, oh yeah. It feels like last time, bro. I feel like I can't be defeated. He gets speed blitz and gets put out instantly, bro. Come on, bro. Stop playing with that boy Mori. The winner is Mori Jin. Throb. Okay, so what's up? So, Mori's finger is throbbing. I'm curious to why. And Ilpio sees this. I know he clocks it, bro. Damn. We cut away now to Moo Park and this guy from the cult, from that, like, hooded cult or whatever. Who went after the mage grandson, bro? He goes, well, I forgot to tell you that I changed my name. I am now Exilus von Lunging, the Bishop of Manjing Sang. You lifted my name. I changed my name to Mujin 10 years ago. Manjin and Mujin. Look, it's almost the same. Don't you think mandioc? Mandioc sang, is it? Yep, the whole arm is on the floor, boy. It's just gone.
Yep.
Then you lifted my name because I changed my name 13 years ago, Mubong. Ah, it's 18 years ago, not 10 years ago. How poor my memory is. These two are just having a conversation about who changed their name first, bro. Like, these niggas is weak. Gee, really? It's 40 years ago. 40 years, Mubong. Huh? Don't tell me my grandpa named me Mujin 65 years ago, which is even before I was born, Mandyuk. This is weak, bro. My grandpa did the same 100 years ago. My name was decided even before the Earth was created. My name was decided before the webtoon was hatched. I'm weak. Man broke the fourth wall. My name was decided before yours was decided, Mandyuk. Please. You're making the webtoon look so cheap. This is a fight between grown men. So they start laughing and hugging and shit like they know each other. But we could have... The whole man's arm is on the floor, bro. What? It's been ages. Are you all right now? Yeah, I'd say it was a miracle. So what are you doing here? Well, you know, I'm here to see you. Oh, don't fib. Are you here to find the other key? Oh, who knows? Who knows? Yo, what's up with these two, bruh? The other key? Obviously, okay. So they hugged each other, obviously, because they have palm attacks on, like, you know, their hand. So they hug each other to get close enough to be like, and then we see them. Stalemate. The level of conversation doesn't match their fight. Wow. You're as strong as before. Ah. Well, you got cocky. You got cocky getting smart with me. It was you. You fought with Tate. So he's getting down. We kind of getting more info on Mori's granddad now. Because Mujin goes like, bro, it was you, nigga. You the one who fought Tae Jin Jin in Gangwon-do. Why? I thought you're still unrivaled. Bro. Dude, nah, this panel goes crazy, bro. So we see. Let me set the scene, bro. This shit is crazy. We see, obviously, these two, they hug it out. They boom, do whatever. He's like, bro, y'all strong. And we see, he has his hand out, and we see, he goes, bah, you're getting cocky with me. And we didn't realize what Mujin was doing when he put the cross up on his fucking, on his hand. You know? We see, he goes, it was you. You're the one who fought Tae Jin Jin in Gangwon-do. He goes, why? I thought you are still unrivaled. And Mujin knows this because I don't remember what chapter it was. But a while ago, when Mori's granddad was fighting old boy, he saw the fucking like shadow or the silhouette of this giant spear or sword while he was in his plane. And now we go to the next panel and we see the same sword being blocked by Mujin's fucking cross, bro. So we know it was this nigga who got Mori's granddad, bro. This panel is gorgeous, bro. This panel is gorgeous, bro. The outside, yeah, right? Them raising the arms inside was cool, but the outside panel just made it perfect, bro. God. Mubong, what's your angle? Ugh. Rah. What is this what you expected? Since I am, such as I am, I can still blow up an island easily. And we know he can, bro. We saw chapter one. He blew up an island instantly, bro, with his palm print. Like, bro. And we see, he goes, lasers up his fucking palm, and he shoots the fucking sword and breaks it. Yeah, he was sandbagging, bro. Fake struggling. He was sandbagging, bro. Crazy. It can't be. His power is, well, is that what you expected? What? The man's arm just grew back, bro. Regeneration. Even his clothes regenerated. Wonder what it is? It's omnipotence. If he can do this, it means all you can do is borrowing powers. Whoa! No fucking way, bro. What am I looking at, bro? What am I looking at, bro? Like, bro. So the guy goes, he says this shit. If he can do this, it means all you can do is borrowing powers. And we see some giant fucking, like, it has to be a god, bro, with a huge sword. And, like, that's what the sword was. It got, the sword was this fucking god, bro. Because we see part of it got obliterated, and I assume that's the part that got beat up by Mubarak, bro. It's god, he says. Nigga, what? It's god, he says. My king of all things, please enlighten the ignorant. I can't stop it. Tastes great. What a great view. I'm weak. This guy's over here drinking water. Bro, what is happening, bro? Nah, this is too much right now, boy. Phew, what's going on? Mr. G, well, how are you? Hi, it's been ages. Look, what's all the fuss about? Look at the dark sky. Is it going to rain today? And we'll see. Oh boy, again, regenerates, puts the sword out. God's fucking here. It's God. That fucking panel is crazy, bro. Bro, this panel is crazy, bro. Please enlighten the ignorant, he says. Go. Great taste. What a great view, he says. Hang in there. Message. Homeless quarter one. Ujiro team. Homeless quarter two. Sindorman team. Are you ready? Haya! Homeless quarter three. Soul Station team. Are you got ready? Okay then. Oops. As the 27th president of the National Homeless Association. What? What? He uncovers his fucking, bro. We thought this was like some clothes and his shit. He like uncovers his cart, bro, and it's all weapons, bro. Battle axes, spears, a giant scroll, a baseball bat, like, brother. The man's loaded, dude. In the name of Hao Yang Xiao from the Six, I order you, National Treasure Cho Yong, National Treasure K2, National Treasure, yo, man, National Treasures. And we see, the man picks up and starts whirling all these fucking weapons around, bro. The Six Hao Yang Xiao National Treasure Collection 108 Agonies Fan Out. Bro, what is happening, bro? Play music. Did I drink too much? This nigga's drunk.
This nigga's drunk.
Did I drink too much? And we see everybody in these stations who he called, like, these homeless crews are all now bang, 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 clacking, making music, making noise and shit. And they're all singing some Christian folklore. And you say, ugh, borrowed power. It can't be. Hao Xiang Yo is a genuine fighter. Then this is Soundwave. Korean folklore, flat. What the fuck? And we see old boy with the weapons is moving his hands, having his wings. He's and throwing, what the fuck? And throwing all his like weapons into the air and shit, bro. Boom, shooting guns, bazookas, all that. And it's evaporating whatever is like appearing or like pushing down on Mujin's fucking cross, bro. It's like evaporating the bottom of it, bro. Clang, clang, clang. Here it comes again. Clang, clang, clang. The beggar from last year. Clang, clang, bro. Everyone going crazy, bro. Yo, why are all these dudes so powerful, bro? The man picks up a staff. He, there's like a spinning thrust, bro. And the wind from this thrust goes crazy, bro. Get a hold of yourself. We might die if we from a small mistake. Whew. Huh. Who is it? The other key. Which do you think it is? I guess you already know, don't you? Grin. What the heck? Yo, what's up with old Omega Boy, bro? Like, he's weird, dude. He grins. And we cut away now from Mubong and shit. Back to our boy Mori Jin. I don't know. I'm not sure who the key is, bro. Back to Mori. Song Park will challenge him, of course. It's Il Pyo. Wait, is Il Pyo the key? It's Il Pyo Park, of course. It's Il Pyo Park. Him again? Now, look up. So after the guy from the six evaporated the bullet from the god, right? That was going on the city. He goes, hey, look up. Mujin looks up. Got homeless out of the six, looks up. He goes, OMG. And all you see is four more of these fucking pillars from the fucking sky, bro. What in the rumbling is happening? Rumbling, rumbling. Dun, dun. That's what happened right now, bro. I'm telling you, bro. Because what? And he goes, time to be punished by heaven, he says. Oh, shit. So we see, as he says that, right, the mage guy who was in the bed gets up and he just goes, what? And heads to the door. Mu Jin goes, yo, P, you better get old boy. She goes, yes, sir. Hands off. And he knocks her back. And she, wiggles out, runs off. Bishop Escalos, who says he can take him? Who says you can take him there? You're making this out of control. Come immediately to backup. So this guy looks on. You still have this. Pah. Having God behind you. You think this world's in your hands? You are still a two-bit hood. He grins. Nice seeing you. And what does he mean by you still have, like, what do you mean by this? And we see, ching, oh boy, dips off. And all the fucking rumbling pillars start vanishing and disintegrating into the sky, bro. Whew! It was hard, ugh. So they really are going to destroy this world. The key, and Mugen looks at his hand, his shit's trembling, bro. He's strained, bro. That shit was hard for him. I ain't gonna lie, it was tough. The key we're looking for, if my guess is right, that is, yeah, your guess is right. You know, they are perverted dudes who keep the world on a string. Gods. The key is the one who can make them fall from the sky. Really? The key is the one who can make them fall from the sky. That's very interesting, bro. Oh my God. We're not gonna get Mori fighting this guy this week. Oh, I'm sad. GOH fighting competition organized by Mugen. Episode 1, Mori Jin, and we see flashback to episode 1. Congrats, you're entitled to participate in the God of High School. Do it fast. We have no time. Yes, sir. One of the purposes of this tournament, the key, episode 13, his level change. Oh, are they gonna explain that Mori is actually the key though? Because that would make sense. But I don't know. The one of the purposes of this tournament, the key, his level is to change. He then, so far, there are three whose levels changed. He has the highest GP in this quarter. It seems that he is a key we're looking for. Nah, I think it might be actually Il Pio, bruh. Because didn't Il Pio's level change too? It's too easy to jump to conclusion. To a hasty conclusion, excuse me. It might be the nature of the martial arts he's using. However, there exists a counter force searching for the key. And we see the hoods. Now we're actually getting an explanation on what the fuck the hoods have been looking for, bro. Because we didn't know. They were just like fucking looking for Mori's granddad and shit. Like we didn't know what the hell they were actually doing. But now I've been looking for this key. There is a counterforce searching for the key. I already found the key we're looking for. Mu Bong, you're always late. And their ultimate goal is 70, 74. The world is worn out, rub-a-dub. Now we will reestablish the world order. In other words, we will conquer this world. 78. An other key, which do you think it is? I guess you already know, don't you? Of course. It's Il Pio Park. So it is Il Pio, bruh. Bishop Mandiok Sang spots Il Park Pio as the key, and the key's identity is gradually being revealed. The key we're looking for. If my guess is right, that is gods. The key is the one who can make them fall from the sky. Do you feel out of trim? I'm not looking down on him, but I don't think he's strong enough to endure your kick. And isn't Jin Hukchan too much for him? What do you think? Strangely, his moves are pretty tricky, which makes it harder to aim his attacks. And his last attack, I could have lost if I didn't hit him first. Clinch. I'm desperate too. I must find my grandpa. So damn, I actually like that. That Mori is saying that even though it looked like a low diff for like on outside, he's kind of saying that it was a harder fight than we really anticipated, bro. Which is interesting. I must find my grandpa. I'd rather not fight with the girl. Well, he is very rigid in some ways. Take your glasses off. Yeah, true. Mori is rigid. He's like, I don't want to fight a nigga in glasses. The best time is the beginning of the game. Do it as soon as it starts. Okay. I'll do my best. Good. 12 years ago. He'll be with us from now on. LPL Park, age 6. My little brother is his grandpa. He is all alone after losing both parents, so be nice to him. My cousin. Yes. Oh, that's old girl. Seung-ah Park and Seung-yung Park. She's age 6 and 7. Pa, he looks so weak. Welcome, LPL. Hello. My family has a legacy. Yongtop Taekyeon, designed as number 87 intangible cultural asset, and there was no boy in my family. He must be aiming to be the successor. So I didn't like him from the first moment. How pathetic. Can you teach me how to kick? For what? Sunga, please. Be nice to him. I'll teach you. I'm weak. My sister. Seung-yeon used to be an all-arounder from schoolwork to Taekyeon. She will be the successor. And we'll see. That's crazy, bro. She bullying our old boy LPL, bro. LPL, look, reading his little Bible, his little journal, whatever. She snatches it. Gah. What's this? Huh? Samu Taekyeon sounds lousy. You can call it Taekyeon, too. Give it to me. It's pressed to me, so give it back. Pah! Then come take it from me. I'm weak. LPO instantly was like, yo, bitch, get my book back. Get my book. Bah, I come faster than you. If you dare. Dare if you can. Oops. At that time, to me, my grandfather was as scary as a ghost. Oh, she got old boy's book wet. Oh, he about to be tight, bruh. Are you okay? Are you hurt anywhere? He goes, huh? Oh, and this is where she starts liking him, because even he didn't even, like, acknowledge she fucked up the book, bro. He was like, yo, you good? Who did this? Confess. And she trembles, and it was, LPO did it. Crazy. And the man got whipped on the calves, bro. Just bah, 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 on the calves. And she just sitting there chilling. Do you know how precious it is? I'm so sorry. Grandpa, please forgive him. Sploot, 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 sploot. And wow. She just let him take the beating, bro. That's crazy. Wow. She's guilty, though. You see it. She's guilty. She sits up. You see the lashes on old boy's leg. The lashes on old boy's leg, bro. Crazy. And she says, since then, I started to like him. And she sees, huh, he's kicking. Huh, crack. Gosh. What? And an unexpected accident. It seemed that Yucheon Park is severely injured. Yeah. Shit. And we see that boy, LPL, when he fought, when old boy, his cousin, fought Shark Boy, got injured. LPL looks tight in the crowd. He looks pissed off, bro. She won't be able to do Taekyeon anymore. You're entitled to participate in the, and of course. And this is where we see what LPL truly wants with his wish, bro. To save his dear friend. You're entitled to participate in the GOH. He goes, ah! I'll become the champion. And he kicks it and breaks the fucking dummy. Which is a nice contrast to the beginning of the flashback where he couldn't kick at all, bro. You know? So we see the amount old boy has leveled up. We see it. I'll become the champion. Next fight, round 2. The atmosphere is getting hotter and hotter. Capital first, Jeonnam, round 2. Round 2. The best timing is the beginning of the game. Now, it's time for me to help him. Pow! GOH, chapter 79, and God, the fucking cliffhanger, bro. Oh, we really ain't gonna get to see that boy, this boy, fight Mori for a minute, bro. The first comment. Oh my God, let me see this first comment, bro. We don't care about your backstory, insignificant garbage. That's crazy, bro. That's wild. Nah, we needed the backstory, bro. We needed, like, it's like, yeah, obviously I would have loved to get right into the fight, but we needed the backstory on Ilpio because he doesn't seem insignificant, bro. Like, he is supposedly the key that these two parties are looking for. He's connected to Mori. Mori has a connection to him. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't seem like he's not important. And we needed to know his motivation for when Mori beats him, it's going to hit harder. You know? When Mori beats him and we realize what he lost, it hits harder, bro. You know? So in my opinion, we needed that. But hey, it is what it is. Anyway. Next joint, I'm just waiting for this. I'm just waiting for Ilpio versus Mori, bruh. I'm looking forward to it. I think Mori beats him, bro. I'm not betting against until I'm proving otherwise. I'm betting on Mori, brother. Until proven otherwise. Because we've seen them clash and it was a tie. So there's nothing for me. There's nothing to show me in the story that Mori can't beat him, you know? Nothing. We haven't seen. Well, that's true. We haven't seen him really fight. We saw them clash. So we know he's kind of saucy, but again, until I'm proven otherwise, I'm not betting against Mori, bro. I'm not doing it. We know he has some secret technique, and we do know his skill set, bro. We know what his fighting style is. He has the upgraded version, or like the like modified version of Ryu Taekwondo. We know what he fights as already. We haven't seen him fight yet, but we know his style. But yeah, that fight is going to be crazy. That's what I'm looking forward to the most, bro. When that comes, it's going to be litty. Litty. But yeah, if you made it to the end of the live reaction, I appreciate y'all so much. If you enjoyed, don't forget to drop a like on the video. It really helped the boy out. Also, drop a sub. I'm on the road to 1K, so a sub would really help out the channel. So yeah, I'm going to see y'all next time. Stay safe out in these streets. And I'm going to see y'all soon. Peace.